Hello class 9, hope you all are preparing for your half yearly exams. Some students have problem in program which I have given in 19th assignment. So I am explaining that program in this video. Theoretical part we have done, now we will revise programs only. Let's start. Program which I have given in my last video. I have given a person is paid rupees 350 for each day he works and fined rupees 30 for each day he remains absent. Write a program to calculate and display his monthly income if he is present for 25 days and remains absent for 5 days. If he in this program given, if he works and fined rupees 30 for each day he remains absent. He remains absent 5 days. First we will write the import Java public class. I am giving this class name is income because it is related to the income. Then public static void main string args, everybody knows about this. Int edi, edi means each day income. Fine previous day absent, sorry, present day ab absent day, monthly income of 30 days and monthly income for 25 days, and this is the final monthly income. Now scanner in is equal to new scanner system dot in system. First we will enter the day, each day income, day, present day and absent day. First we will enter these, then we will write the data type of these. Now we will start the program. If day equal 30, if days are equal to 30, then monthly income, each day income multiply by d, d is 30, so that each day income 350 multiply by 30. If days equal 25, if days are equal to 25, then second monthly income for 25 days, edi, each day income multiply days, 25 days, then this is the final income, monthly income. This is monthly income of 30 days and this is monthly income of 25 days. Now we will minus the income 30 minus 25. Then system out println monthly income after 5 days absent. Then we will print this. Here I am writing the output also. Each day income rupees 350. Therefore monthly income rupees 350 multiply 30. Then 10,500 rupees. Number of days he is present 25, so that 25 days income is rupees 8750. Number of days he is absent, which has given in the program 5 days, the amount he did not get because he was absent, so that this income he will not get. This is the 1750 income he will not get. He will get only 8750 rupees. This is the monthly income, final monthly income. Now second program, this also I have given in as homework. In a competitive examination there are 150 questions. One candidate got 80% correct and the other candidates 72% correct. Write a program in Java to calculate and display the correct answer each candidate got. Means who got 80% correct, their answers, correct answers, and who got 72% their answers. This I will write, by mistake I have written 72, this is 75, we will change it 75 because I have used 75 in the program. So that import Java this same class, we will change candidate, public static void main string args. Int, this is total questions, TOTQUES. This is answers. Scanner in, new scanner system dot in, system out print, ln, sorry, ln I have not written, system out print ln, enter total questions. Now we will enter the total questions. If total questions equal to 80%, if correct answers are 80%, then total question multiply 80 upon 100. If total questions are equal to 75% correct answer, then we will find the 75 of the total questions.
then system out println. The correct answer each candidate got plus ANS. If they have got 80%, answer will be this. If they have got 75 correct answer, the answer will be, the questions is this. So that in 80% correct answer, 120 questions correct out of 150. In 75 correct, 112.5 means 113 questions correct out of 150 questions. Hope you understood. Now next question is, here we are doing swap. Swap, in swapping we are changing the values. X values become Y and Y values become X. This type of program also coming in your exam. In this program, a class named JavaSwap example is being declared, which contains the main method. Inside the main, two integers type variables are declared, that is X and Y, and are initialized with values, X values 10 and Y values 20. Now in this program, you have to swap the value that is present in X to Y, and that of Y in X, means X became Y and Y became X. After swapping, the current value of X is 20 and Y is 10. The statement system out println value of X is plus X. After swapping, the value of X will be 20 and the value of Y will be 10. Now we are making the program import Java. Import I small, you will write I small. Import java.io. Import java.util. We will use util program here. Import java.util, public class Java swap example, public static void main string args. We will write this bracket here, string, and we can write after args this. Both of brackets are same. We can use this bracket here also. We can use this bracket here also. Suppose we have taken int x is equal to 10, int y is equal to 20. System out println before swapping. System out println before swapping, the value is this. After swapping, swap the value of swap x and y. Now it will be swapping x and y. Public static void swap int x int y. Int temp is equal to x, x is equal to y, and y is equal to 10. Means here temp, this is a variable temp. Temp is equal to the x variable and x is equal to y, so that y is equal to temp. Now the value of x became the value of y after swapping, and the value of y became the value of x. System out println after swapping, system out println value of x is plus x, means it will become 20. System out println value of y is plus y. Now it, after swapping, the value will become 10. Next program. Program to find the largest and smallest of three integers. We will use three integers here, and in this program we will find the largest and smallest integers. First we will write the statement, import javautil.scanner. We will write a star also here, public class main, then public static void main string args. This is creating scanner to accept radius of a circle. Here we will scanners, new scanner system.in. Now system out println, welcome in Java program to find largest and smallest of three number. This is the statement which we will, like a message which want, when program will give output, that message will come. System out println, enter first number. Here we will write first number, then it is the data type of first number. Then enter second number, it is the data type of second number. Then enter third number, it is the data type of third number. Now we will find the int max, maximum value. If int max is equal to first value, then if second is greater than max, curly bracket, int max is equal to second. If we are using first is greater than max, then max is equal to first. If we are using second is greater than max, then max is equal to second value. If third is greater than max, then max will become third value. Means in this system out println, the largest number plus max. If this is first, then first value will printing here. If this is second, then second value. If this is third, the third value will be Now this is for find the minimum, smallest value. If second is less than minimum value, then minimum value becomes second. If third is less than minimum, then minimum value is third, otherwise first. System out printed the largest number. Sorry, this is the smallest number. Not this is by mistake I have written largest. This is the smallest. The smallest number plus min. Now the output is which message I have written. This message will come. Welcome in Java program to find the largest and smallest of three numbers. Enter the first number 1, second number 2, and third number is 3. Then largest of three number 1, 2, 3 is 3. This is the output. Smallest of three number 1, 2, and 3 is 1. This is the output of the program. Now, Java program to check whether given number is divisible by 5. Means it is the number which we are entering, it is divisible by 5 or not. For this, import Java, then we will write class name, public static args. First, we will take a int n, number we will. Scanner, as we can take, scanner in is equal to new scanner system.in. In each and every program, I have written different, but you will write system scanner in is equal to new scanner system.in. System out print error. First, we will enter any number. Then, we will declare the data type of that number. Now, we will put the condition. If n modulus 5, if when we are dividing that number which we have entered by 5 and modulus become means remainder become 0, then system out print error. N is divisible by 5. The message will this. Otherwise, else system out println n is not divisible by 5. If remainder is not become 0 equal to 0 and remainder will come 1 or 2, then it is not divisible by 5. If remainder will come 0, then message will come divisible by 5. Then we will close the programs 3 times because 3 times we have opened 1, 2. And this is 3. So that is this to be closed here. So that we close 3 times here. This is the output. Enter any number. Suppose we have entered 45. And 45 is divisible by 5. Yes. Enter any number. If we have entered 16. 16 is not divisible by 5. Because when we will divide 5 by 16. So one remainder will come. So that it is not divisible by 5. When we will divide 45 by 5. 0 will come, remainder will 0, so that it will be divided by 5. Now Java program to check whether number is divisible by 5 and 11. Here we are checking two numbers. First we will write the message, import Java divisible by 5 and 11. Then same int number we have taken, same. Enter the number to check whether it is divisible by 5 and 11. Then we will declare the data type of that number. If number, first we will divide this number by 5 and became 0, or number divisible by 11 or became 0, then message will come system out println given number plus number is divisible by 5 and 11. Otherwise, system out println in given number is not divisible by 5 and 11. So that 3 times bracket open, then I have closed 3 times in one line. But you will close that different line. No space is here, so that I have using this.